a charter member. We relinquished our sovereignty. We are no longer a sovereign country. The republic we once were is no more. Also, when we look at the diplomacy by deception through the Tavistock Institute, the operational research, and the undeclared war, we have a massive undeclared war. I'm going to just define this for all of you right now as the source documents tell us. One of the documents I'm referring to right now is on our website. It's the NASA war plan. We've had this document on our website for some time. You can go to the search bar at the top of the home page and type it in. It's also entitled Future Strategies Issues, Future Warfare, circa 2025. And to simplify it, we simply call it the NASA War Plan. On page 110, this is what it says, quote, war's name is even spelled. Many of you are aware of that. The Constitution was set aside during the Civil War and has never been in effect since. Again, this book is Fruit from a Poisonous Tree by Melvin Stamper, S-T-A-M-P-E-R. Also, you will find this in that book, and you can also just look at this on your search engine. It is a statement from Colonel Edward Mandel House, H-O-U-S-E,
Deborah,
and it was...
Can you get into your mic a little bit? You're fading a little bit. Thank you.
Absolutely. Thank you, Matt. This is a statement by Colonel Edward Mandel House, and this was stated in a private meeting with Woodrow Wilson, who was the president from 1913 to 1921. Quote, very soon, every American will be required to register their biological property, that's you and your children, in a national system designed to keep track of the people and that will operate under the ancient system of pledging. By such methodology, we can compel people to submit to our agenda, which will affect our security as a chargeback for our fiat currency. In other words, they knew eventually we might discover some of the fraud, but sadly, we've accepted this fiat currency, and the bar attorneys have been largely responsible for this fraud as well as our teachers. But moving ahead, the quote continues, every American will be forced to register or suffer, not being able to work and earn a living. They will be our chattel or our property, and we will hold the security interest over them forever by operation of the law merchant under the scheme of secured transactions. Americans, by unknowingly or unwittingly delivering the bills of lading, our birth certificates, to us, will be rendered bankrupt and insolvent, secured by their pledges. They will be stripped of their rights and given a commercial value designed to make us a profit, and they will be none the wiser, for not one man in a million could ever figure our plans. And if by accident one or two should figure it out, we have an arsenal of plausible deniability. After all, this is the only logical way to fund government, by floating liens and debts to the registrants in the form of benefits and privileges. This will inevitably reap us huge profits beyond our wildest of expectations and leave every American a contributor to this fraud, which we will call social insurance. Social security. Without realizing it, every American will unknowingly be our servant, however begrudgingly. The people will become helpless and without any hope for their redemption, and we will employ the high office of presidency